everyone. This is Darrell Evans of the 1984 World Champion Detroit Tiger. My favorite show to be on is the Sports Circus with Big Sal.
Welcome to Sports Circus. I'm your Ringmaster Sal, live from the AMP TV studios here in fabulous Las Vegas. That's AAMP TV. Today's show is brought to you in part by Legal Shield, providing legal protection and peace of mind. Legal Shield can help with traffic tickets, texting and driving, DUIs, court appearances, estate planning, even contracts given to people they don't understand, plus a whole lot more. For more information, contact Legal Shield at 213-245-1305. That's 213-245-1305, or visit them online for more information at nocourt.us. That's nocourt.us. All right, and a big welcome in everybody listening in on Magic 97.9 FM right here in Las Vegas. And a big hello to our friends on our CBS, NBC, and Fox Sports affiliates from coast to coast, as well as those on iHeart, Spotify, those watching on hotel television in 650,000 hotel rooms from coast to coast, and those also watching on YouTube. Make sure you subscribe to the Sports Circus on YouTube as well. Back here with two-time Super Bowl champion and American Ninja Warrior, this guy, yes. Tyrone. Look at this guy. Got the big ring behind him, man, this massive ring. Love it.
I'm on it, Sal. The green screen, the rings, the patch, man, technology allows you to do so much. And every time I look at that ring, it just takes me back to that game. And again, it's only 53 other guys that can actually say they have that ring right there. Out of all the guys that's ever played this game, man, it's just a great feeling just to be able to call that mine.
Do you have to have this massive ring just so you could tell everybody that you got it? They don't have it. I think that's really what it's about, isn't it?
Hey, that's what it's all about. That's what it's all about, Sal. So you got to parade it. You got to show it off. That's hard work, man. That is hard work. Hard work.
That is hard work. Hey, you know, there's another guy that's with us that knows just a little bit of something about hard work. Let's let him introduce himself.
Yes.
Hey, what's up, everyone? Walt Harris here, former NFL player. Great to be in the building. Great to be part of this whole group. My man, T. Pool and Seth, great to have you guys here.
Right. Hey, big Walt, round of applause. Right. I've got a couple of really good corners on my sides here. Yes. So I feel pretty good. Of course, if they need support, somebody's going to get an elbow in the head or something like that from the middle. But generally speaking, I feel very safe with these guys over here. All right, Walt, welcome in. Former Chicago yes. Bears, San Francisco 49ers. You had a lot of people really liked you when you were in Chicago, for sure. Now, I can say that because I'm a Bears guy. Very excited. Of course, I'm representing for my White Sox right here. But I love the fact that, look, there are some people that come on that bedazzled the crowd. They loved them. They were fan favorites at a whole bunch of levels. And then there are others you're like, okay, tell us your story. But Walt, you're one of those guys that, look, you know a little bit of something about where this guy is from too, because you guys are from the same place.
Same place, homeboys.
Yes. LG, LaGrange, Georgia, I tell you. We were just talking about spitting out a lot of talent out of LaGrange, Georgia. And so it was great to just see T-Pool play and be a part of that whole legacy in LaGrange, Georgia. So great to be next to T-Pool, my man, and you guys.
First-round draft pick corners.
Yes.
This is pretty cool. From the same small town. This is nuts. I mean, what are the odds of that?
Yeah, it's
crazy. What LaGrange does.
I'm in the sports book. I'm in the sports book right now. And as you can see behind me, there's a tote board. And this tote board is for the different odds for different events and stuff like that. I want to know what the odds would have been. Number one, of somebody coming out of LaGrange, Georgia, let alone two, let alone, by the way, two first-round draft picks. How do you like that? That's very exciting.
Yeah, it's very exciting. But, you know, it's a lot of guys that have come out of LaGrange now. Mike Cameron, baseball, you know, there were guys before Walt and myself, you know, John Johnson, Nate Hill. You know, you can go back and there's a whole list of guys, and there's still guys coming out of LaGrange. Now, of course, myself and Walt, we've always talked about going back and continuing to do things in the neighborhoods of LaGrange because it's greatly needed now. But, you know, it's just tremendous just to see someone else come from the same hometown. So when they talk on Monday Night Football and they say where this person went to college, and then they say where their hometown was, and you see LaGrange pop up on that screen, man, it's just a blessing.
Yeah, absolutely. I agree. When you think about it, you know, like you were just saying, Tipu, there were other greats before us. And so it was great. It was like a tradition. They gave us more of a desire to try to do more and do the same and do better. So when you have something to model after, you know, we both had two different paths, but it got us to the same place where we wanted to be.
Yeah. Now, I'm going to start with this question right here. I'm going to go back, okay? I'm going to go back, Walt, 1991. Now, see, Sal, this is one thing Walt has over me now. They won a championship. They won a state title now. They won a state title. Now, I'm gonna take Walt back. I want you to tell everybody who's listening and watching now. This is going to be your story. Sit back in your chair, take that deep breath, and tell us 1991 against Colquitt County. All right, you guys beat them 17-16. Somebody blocked a kick. Man, walk me through it, because that was the turning point. That was basically what sealed that victory, man. The huddle to the blocking of the kick. Man, walk us through it.
Yeah. Well, what actually happened, me blocking the kick was actually earlier in the game. I didn't know that it was going to have that type of effect on the game because it was an extra point. And so on that last drive, we were down, and I ended up intercepting the ball to end up bringing the offense back on the other side to get ready to go down and score. We were not able to score, but the very fact that I blocked the extra point, now we just needed to kick a field goal. And that field goal, actually, Scott Simon kicked it and ended the game. And so had I not blocked that extra point, it would have been a tie game. Who would have known what would happen going into overtime? So you never know what happens throughout a game. And so that's why each play is important. And so it was an exciting time, man. And you're looking back now, you have something to hang on your shoulder and be proud of that. You helped to contribute to a national championship overall for that year. So I'm totally excited about it and still glad.
Yeah, that was that. It's sad. That was so big because LaGrange not only won the championship, but, Walt, didn't you guys win the national? Like, you guys out of all the high schools in the United States, LaGrange was number one.
Yeah, I don't even know how they really did that whole ranking, but I remember going into that last game, we were ranked number two in the nation going into the state championship game. And so after we won that game, we moved up. I'm not sure if the number one team in the nation that was ranked during the time that they lost or not, but we moved up to the number one seed or national champions. And so outside of just winning the state championship, we were also state and national champions. So you're right, T-Pool. Nice. I do have one up on you, man. But right behind you have something a lot bigger than that, and that's that ring.
Well, he's got that big ring behind him. I think that's what it is.
It's huge.
Hey, got to display it.
You got
to
do it.
That's all right. You know, hey, listen, if I had it, I would be displaying it too. Okay, so let's go back to post high school. Post Miss State, let's talk a little bit about Miss State for a minute. Now, when you were in the SEC, when you were playing at Miss State, talk about how the SEC has grown in recruiting from where when you were there to where it stands today. Today, it's almost like playing in the NFL already in college. Isn't it crazy?
Yeah. For me, looking at it now, how it is now, it's totally on a different level. Like you just mentioned, it is on a level that we were not used to back when I was being recruited. When I was recruited, you know, you came in, Starksville at that time was not a lot that was going on. I mean, really, it was almost like a a college placed in a place of nowhere, but now everything is grown and recruiting is on a different level right now. So that's just the way it works.
Kind of remind me of Oxford. You know, when I, one day I went out when I got done with my undergrad, I was out hunting around for a law school, and I had been through 41 different schools across the country, spent a lot of time in the East Coast and the Southeast Conference. I remember going to Starkville, going to Ole Miss. I was up in Oxford. And, you know, Oxford kind of reminded me of being in that movie Back to the Future, you know, with the square. And that's just kind of reminded me that's what it was like. But the little towns, I love that in the Southeast. A lot of people are listening from coast to coast. They have no idea what we're talking about here unless they've seen maybe the movie Back to the Future. Is that a fair depiction of the town?
Absolutely. Absolutely. And going back to Starkville, and I think that was one of the good things about it for me, because it was a place of focus. You didn't have so many distractions going on in different big cities as they are now than what we did in Starkville. So it required you to be a lot more focused on the task at hand. And so for me, it worked out well for me, because it's all about distractions and staying focused.
It really is. All right, Tyrone, listen, give us your thoughts and take us to break.
Well, I know what, like Walt said, distractions. Myself, I can agree with that, coming from that small town in Ford Valley. Nothing there to do, so nothing but focus. But Walt, man, you did some great things, and I want to get back and talk about some more great things that you've accomplished. But for those who are listening and watching, I want you to continue to stay tuned for some more Sports Circus, because we have the great Walt Harris, all pro Walt Harris, on the Sports Circus. See you when we return.
Do you have any questions about legal issues? Have you ever been stopped by a police officer and issued a ticket that you're scared to deal with? Have you ever been in trouble with the law and don't know what to do? Do you have a will or power of attorney question? Is your home being foreclosed upon and you don't know where to turn? Maybe you were given a contract that you don't understand. For freedom and a worry-free solution, call for Legal Shield today at 213-245-1305. It's that simple. You will have access to high-quality law firms that will fight for you for less than a dollar a day. Peace of mind is just a call away. That's for Legal Shield. Call 213-245-1305 or visit us at nocourt.us. It's justice for all and not justice for some. Are you a small business owner or pursuing the dream of starting your own company? Do you know where to start or how to grow that existing business? The American Business Trust Company has the answers you need. The American Business Trust Company can help you with startup capital, business strategy, sales and marketing, and establishing your company with a physical location or on the internet. You decide. You bring the idea, the American Business Trust Company can help with the rest. For a free evaluation, you may visit them online at abtrustco.com. That's abtrustco.com, or call them at 657-600-1876. That's the American Business Trust Company, 657-600-1876. Call them today. They can help your business right away.
This is Sal Tuzzolino, host and remaster of The Sports Circus. Why listen to the same old dog and pony show that you've heard all day long? The Sports Circus covers everything that other shows don't or are too scared to cover. There's no primetime show like it out here that'll punch you in the mouth and you'll beg for more. You can call in and participate with our chaos if you dare. Join me and celebrity guests for Havoc and Mayhem weekdays at 5 p.m. Pacific here on Amp TV, or stream the show live at thesportscircus.com. Remember, folks, it's a circus and we prove it every day.
Could you use a little extra money right now? If you'd like to borrow up to $100,000 and get pre-approved in minutes, call the number we'll give you at the end of this commercial. Our lending partners have already loaned millions of dollars to individuals just like you, and we're ready to lend you up to $100,000 if you qualify. Even if your credit is not perfect, you could use the money to pay off high-interest credit cards, for home renovations, or consolidate existing debt. You can get flexible, easy-to-pay terms. The consultation to find out if you qualify is free. To find out if you qualify for our special financing program, call call this toll-free number 24 hours a day. 800-335-1376. Important terms and conditions apply. Not all applicants will qualify. Loan amount, annual percentage rate, and term will vary depending on creditworthiness. Applying does not guarantee approval. Account approval is subject to verification and confirmation of your credit history and acceptance by a lender. If you choose to apply for a loan through us, a consumer report will be obtained to evaluate your creditworthiness in connection with your application for credit.
You're watching the Sports Circus, and I am Brian Urlacher.
Welcome back. I am two-time Super Bowl champion and American Ninja Warrior Tyrone Poole. I'm here working that thing today with the great ringmaster himself, Sal. I'm about to call him Sonar. But you know what? We have Sonar, who is the engineer, and he pops in every once in a while to give his take on what's happening. And also, we have a great guest today, none other than the first rounder, All-Pro Walt Harris himself. This segment is brought to you. There you go, right there. For those who are looking, you just saw him pop up on the screen. But this segment is brought to you by the Tyrone Poole 38 Foundation. Tyrone Poole 38 Foundation, we do the three things. We help in fitness, we help in education and humanitarian work, but our greatest prize is to help refill, reform, and restore success in all of the family's lives. So if you want to learn more about the Tyrone Poole 38 Foundation or you want to donate, just go to TyronePoole38Foundation.org. Again, that's TyronePoole38Foundation.org to the R to the G. So now I'm going to kick this thing over. Actually, I'm going to throw the ball because he's a baseball man. I'm going to throw it over to the ringmaster himself, Sal. There he is. Tossing his ball
all right
in the air.
We got the ball. We're ready for you. Big welcome back to everybody listening in on iHeartRadio, Spotify, and our CBS, NBC, and Fox Sports affiliates from coast to coast, as well as Magic 97.9 FM right here in Las Vegas. And a big hello to our friends over in Honolulu on CBS Sports 1500 KHKA. Down over in sunny Southern California, KCAA, our NBC News, CNBC Financial, and CBS Sports affiliate there. And a big hello to our friends down in Corpus Christi, Texas, and the greater Houston market on CBS Sports, KSIX, 95.1 FM, 96.1 FM, and 1230 AM, as well as our friends over in Boston, WBNW, 1120 on the AM dial and 102.9 FM. Back here with two-time Super Bowl champion and American Ninja Warrior, Tyrone Poole, and we also have All-Pro cornerback,
yes,
and veteran from the great LaGrange, yes, Georgia. That nobody, let me tell you something, folks. If you don't know about this place, just check it out. Go ahead and Google great athletes from LaGrange, Georgia, and these two guys, yes, are from there, along with a slew of others. Man, you got champions left, right, and center. Actually, I got them to the right. Actually, to the right and to the left. Everything's reversed around the camera. Yeah, I can't help myself. All right. Hey, Tyrone, put your finger up there again, would you?
Hey, there he goes. Scratch his ear. His ear itching.
That's right. All right. Hey, listen. All right. So I got a couple of superstar corners on either side of me here. And let me ask you guys something that we see in all sports. Now, usually we see this when an athlete will turn maybe 30, 31. The injury bug kind of comes around a little bit. And it's weird. It doesn't matter what sport it is. We see the injury bug come around. It doesn't matter what kind of shape you're in. It just happens. Now, I know we've all seen this. So it doesn't matter whether you're playing football, baseball, basketball, hockey. Stick with the four major food groups of sports. Why is it that we see this, even though, I mean, look, both of you guys are in tremendous shape. Tyrone, you're in playing shape. I know that for sure, at 4% body fat. And so even at 30, 31 years of age, why is it? Now, the big contracts tend to come in some sports at right around 30 years of age, maybe the late 20s, early 30s in some cases. But why is it that even if you're in tremendous shape, that players are getting injured? Walt, let's start out with you real quick.
I don't know. You know, they always say it's father time. But to me, you know, as a defensive back, that sounds so early to me, being at the age that I am in right now. You're talking about 31. I wish I can give those days back again. But I'm not sure. You know, for me, you know, what I did learn over the years is just all about training and trying to be in the best shape and health as possible and being aware of your body. And sometimes, you know, guys don't do as much as they should do during the off season. Now, you mentioned about guys are in the best shape, but who knows what type of shape they're really in, because it's an all around type of ordeal. You have to be mentally strong, physically and well rounded in all areas. And so what looks good on the outside might be that those guys are not as foundational sound on all areas. And Tyrone would know a whole lot more about this than I am, because as you see, he's 4% body fat and tea. I got to get back to that again, man. You're looking good.
Hey, man, Walt, you looking good yourself, brother, man. I'm telling you, for all those who are watching us on Amp TV, Hotel TV, Facebook, you guys see Walt. And for those listening, you got to sign up and subscribe so you can start seeing who we have in and on the Sports Circus. But what I think, guys, how they get injured, I think it goes into a little bit of the training. Yes, they are lifting weights. So when I say training, I'm talking about proper training. Now, we've all heard the term practice makes perfect, but perfect practice makes perfect. So I think perfect training prevents a lot of injuries. Now, you're not going to stop injuries, but you will prevent, I believe, career-threatening injuries. And what I mean about training, we are so concerned about working those primer muscles. Primer meaning the big muscles, like Optimus Prime. You know, those are the big muscles, whether it's the quadriceps. So we work the quadriceps, and most of the exercises they do, lower body, works the quads. But they don't work on those small secondary muscles, those ligaments. And that's where I think a lot of balancing comes in, doing exercises where you're tossing balls back and forth, maybe medicine balls of different weights, which it requires the primer muscles and the ligaments and tendons to work together. And I think when you see these guys run and do a cut and they go down with an ACL injury, I think it's because the primer muscle was too strong for that secondary muscle or those ligaments, and that is what caused the injury. One of the reasons.
Yeah. And also just over time, you know, sometimes you get so used to a certain regimen over time. And like Steve Poole said, you know, you're not really focusing on those other areas. And before you know it, 10 years, 8 years down the road, you're still staying on that same consistent structure that you've been on, but you haven't made any changes. And so over time, it's going to bite you. For me, the latter part of my career, I really felt the best part of my career, because one of the things that I did notice that I had to do was do something different than I didn't do early on in my career. So I started training, paying a whole lot more attention to my body, to the foods that I eat, and all those, like Tyrone said, those smaller muscles that really hold up a lot of the other muscles that you don't think about. And so once I did that, I felt a whole lot better and told myself, I wish I would have known this on the earlier part of my career.
And a big welcome back to everybody listening in on our CBS, NBC, and Fox Sports affiliates, to watching us in hotel television and streaming us on YouTube. Also, make sure you go to YouTube and hit subscribe. Listen, Walt Harris, as a all-pro, all that experience you have sitting in hotel rooms and being on the road, and Tyrone, I know you can both speak to this, but Walt, let me ask you a question. For all those people watching on hotel TV right now in 650,000 rooms coast to coast, what advice, if they're not playing football, can you give them for something simple, for staying in some kind of reasonable shape, if they're just road warriors, right? They're constantly going from city to city to city doing their thing. And let's face it, they don't have a lot of time to work out. What can they do?
Well, I mean, if you're in the hotel, I mean, first and foremost, that hotel hopefully has some type of gym, things that they can do at the end of the day. But just some of the smaller things, you know, just go out, get out, get moving, get walking. There are things that you can do in a room that does not require weights. But I would encourage you to always keep your cardio up. One of the biggest things for me is just those endorphins. One of the things that we have to pay more attention to is pushing those endorphins out, because that really helped us deal with a lot of mental health issues, because endorphins minimize our knowledge on pain. And that pain could be on the mental side. It could be on the physical side. And so when we don't exercise, when we don't excrete a lot of energy, then we start dealing with a whole lot more issues. And that's where last month was the month of mental health. So that was one of the things that I was encouraged, guys. Just get moving, do something, and don't just, because it's easy to sit and watch TV.
Okay, so Tyrone, now I'm going to turn to you, and let's talk about the nutrition side a little bit, right? So we've got good cardio input over here from Walt, but let's talk a little bit about the nutrition side. What can we do for if we're sitting in a hotel room? We're trying to stay away from the mini bar, step away from the mini bar and the M&Ms and the cupcakes or whatever it is that they've got in there. What could they do from a health side, from a nutritional side, to keep themselves more engaged in what they're supposed to be doing and trying to get or maintain maybe that 4% body fat?
Leave your money at home. Leave your money, everything at home if you can, because all those vending machines and everything there from
now
the
leave
hotel
your credit
store
card at home too, though.
Yeah, your credit card, everything. But you know, I believe it's okay to eat a little bit of sugar. It's the amount that you eat. Now, I have a thing where I call mine a 7-5-2 diet. 7 days out of the week, 5 days, I eat as healthy as I can. 2 days, I splurge. I never splurge back to back. And if I do splurge, splurge means like could be donuts, hamburgers, pizza. I do it at the high point of the day for my activities. And most of my activities, my high point is between 12 and 3 o'clock. So if I eat that, so to speak, bad food during that time, I burn it off before I go to bed. And I think that's where most people have problems, because they go to bed with all that late eating. And then health wise, it turns into fat when you wake up the next morning.
You know, I had this conversation with Rocco Kelly, who does the show for the Sports Angle at 6 p.m. in Las Vegas on Magic 97.9 FM. We talked about this. I'm like, stop eating late night and eat a little earlier.
Yes.
I mean, come on. Yes. Think about this, guys. I mean, look, you can't eat a pizza at 9 p.m. and then go to bed at 10. It just doesn't work that way. You know what I mean?
Don't work. Exactly.
That's crazy. Tell you what, we're going to be back here in just a few minutes with a couple of great corners on either side. I got Tyrone Pole, two-time Super Bowl champion, American Ninja Warrior. I got All-Pro Walt Harris over here. We're in great hands. Back here in a few minutes. Don't go anywhere. Last more to come.
Do you have any questions about legal issues? Have you ever been stopped by a police officer and issued a ticket that you're scared to deal with? Have you ever been in trouble with the law and don't know what to do? Do you have a will or power of attorney question? Is your home being foreclosed upon and you don't know where to turn? Maybe you were given a contract that you don't understand. For freedom and a worry-free solution, call for Legal Shield today at 213-245-1305. It's that simple. You will have access to high-quality law firms that will fight for you for less than a dollar a day. Peace of mind is just a call away. That's for Legal Shield. Call 213-245-1305 or visit us at nocourt.us. It's justice for all and not justice for some. Are you a small business owner or pursuing the dream of starting your own company? Do you know where to start or how to grow that existing business? The American Business Trust Company has the answers you need. The American Business Trust Company can help you with startup capital, business strategy, sales and marketing, and establishing your company with a physical location or on the internet. You decide. You bring the idea. The American Business Trust Company can help with the rest. For a free evaluation, you may visit them online at abtrustco.com. That's abtrustco.com, or call them at 657-600-1876. That's the American Business Trust Company, 657-600-1876. Call them today. They can help your business right away.
This is Sal Tuzzolino, host and remaster of The Sports Circus. Why listen to the same old dog and pony show that you've heard all day long? The Sports Circus covers everything that other shows don't or are too scared to cover. There's no primetime show like it out here that'll punch you in the mouth and you'll beg for more. You can call in and participate with our chaos if you dare. Join me and celebrity guests for Havoc and Mayhem weekdays at 5 p.m. Pacific here on Amp TV, or stream the show live at thesportscircus.com. Remember, folks, it's a circus and we prove it every day.
That's the sound of sizzling, dry-aged USDA Prime Wagyu and Angus steaks from UppercutChops.com. They're best-in-class filet mignons, New York steaks, and the king of all steaks, the tomahawk and cowboy cut ribeyes, are the best in the business. Even their Prime Wagyu burgers will likely be the best you've ever had. Browse the full selection of steaks and chops at UppercutChops.com from the comfort of your home or on your mobile device. UppercutChops.com delivers all-natural, dry-aged USDA Prime Wagyu and Angus steaks and chops directly to your door. store without the hassle of going to the grocery store and fight crowds to pick from a small selection of average at best meats with injected steroids, fillers, and coloring added to look good. Find out what's for dinner at uppercutchops.com or call 702-799-9935. That's 702-799-9935. 702-799-9935. Or make your selection directly at uppercutchops.com.
This is Randy Grimes, formerly of the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, and you're listening to the Sports Circus.
Welcome back to Sports Circus. I'm your Ringmaster Sal, live from the AMP TV mobile studio here in fabulous Las Vegas. That's AAMP TV. This segment brought to you in part by Kelly Vegas, helping people create and host their very own radio, TV, or multimedia talk show. Kelly Vegas can help them to reinvent themselves. Maybe they've been sitting around the house trying to figure out what their next move is, or maybe sitting in hours of traffic trying to figure out, I don't want to do this anymore. What else can we do? Well, Kelly Vegas can help. To learn more, check them out at CaliVegas.com. That's CaliVegas.com, or give them a call at 949-445-1119. 949-445-1119. All right. And a big welcome back to everybody listening in on Magic 97.9 FM right here in Las Vegas and our CBS, NBC, and Fox Sports affiliates from coast to coast, iHeartRadio, Spotify, and those watching on Hotel TV in 650,000 rooms from coast to coast, as well as those streaming at YouTube and Facebook. Thanks for joining us. Make sure on YouTube you hit subscribe. Back here with All-Pro and Pro Bowl cornerback Walt Harris. Walt, thanks for joining us again.
Thanks. This is great to be a part of you with you guys.
Hey, listen, this is a lot of fun. We had Tyrone with us in the last couple of segments. He had to run off. We sent him over to the Everglades. You know, he sent me there a few weeks ago, and now it's actually my turn to send him to the Everglades.
Uh-oh. You hope he comes back.
Yeah, well, he'll come back. Now, he's struggling with that 4% body fat. He'll be fast enough to beat anything out there, no question.
Yeah, right, he's so, a ninja, so, you know, so he should be fine.
All right. Well, you know, he was that track star guy, too. Now, did you also run track as well?
I did run track. I ran track in high school. Wanted to run track on a collegiate level, but for some reason that kind of coincided with the spring practice with the coach, with Coach Cheryl, and that was something that he didn't like. He frowned on it, so we kind of stayed away from it.
Well, that's interesting. I was also in track in the off season too. What events did you do?
My main specialty was the hurdles, 110 hurdles, as well as the long distance hurdles. And I really didn't that. Yeah. I love the hurdles, the 110 hurdles, but did not like the 300 hurdles at all.
Yeah. Well, probably because you get into a rhythm doing the 110, right? Yes. Couple steps jump, right? But it's a little bit different in the long distance because you got that in-between jump, kind of throw your rhythm off, right?
Yeah, I my flexibility was extremely well as well, so it was very easy for me to just evolve over the hurdle. And like you said, it was a rhythm. And it, over time, over the years, it just became my specialty. I had my steps down, you know, and it was just a matter of me stepping over the hurdles. I may end up going to state my junior and sophomore senior year and end up second runner-up in the state. So I almost had it, but couldn't finish it up.
Yeah, but it still deserves an astounding round of applause.
Thanks.
Yes, thank you very much. A little bit of Elvis for your soul. Of course, this is Vegas, right? And, you know, this is the one place I have to tell you, for all you people listening from coast to coast and those watching, let me tell you something. This is the only city in America where you could go to the grocery store, you could go to the gas station, you can go to the bank and the post office, and you'll see Elvis Presley four times in one day. That's just how it is. You got to think about that. I mean, look, I'm surprised Elvis hasn't walked through here in the sports book. It doesn't matter what hour it is either, Walt.
You're talking about legacy. He's not here, but he's still here.
That's still right. Elvis is everywhere, right? I mean, that's what we say about God. God is everywhere. So is Elvis, especially here in Vegas. Oh, all man. Right. So So let's go back to that track and field. Did you ever try to do any long jump, triple jump, high jump? Because you got big hops, right? So I would imagine if you had the flexibility that you would have been a good jumper as well.
Well, we had a lot of talent on our track team, especially obviously LaGrange. And so we had guys that really specialize in triple jump and long jump. So, you know, our coach allowed us to just pick out a few things that we were good at. And let the elite stay at the elite level. And I could jump a little bit, but hurdles and running was my specialty at the end of the day. And so I told my coach, hey, let me just get you these 10 points and I'm good. That's just the way my mentality was. I didn't like anything else.
Now look at the guys that played your position around the league. Now you played for a lot of years around the league. How many of those corners, or even the DBs, even the safeties, right? How many of them were also track stars? Percentage.
Yeah, that's a good question. I don't have to look that up, but I would have to assume that a lot of these guys at this stage ran track because, you know, guys are a lot faster now, it seems. Guys are much more in shape, and it would be hard to imagine a lot of the, especially defensive backs, those guys at that skill position not having a two-sport specialty.
Yeah, and that's the funny thing. If you look across all levels of professional sports, how many of those professional athletes, as we welcome everybody back on our CBS, NBC, and Fox Sports affiliates, and also those watching on hotel television, listening in on iHeart and Spotify, here with Walt Harris, all-pro cornerback, many, many years in the league, Bears, Colts, Skins, Niners. And look, talking about these two-sport athletes, we say, all right, you're good at two sports, but just like what you were saying before, being here in Las Vegas, I think this was in between segments, we're talking about the ability to compete in certain things, but maybe the contract won't allow you. So you're talking about an arm wrestling gig, mm-hmm. you know, here in Las Vegas, if I recall, right?
Yeah.
So how many contract violations could that be now? Because, you know, with all the mad money on the table today in today's games, how many restrictions are really put on the players now versus when you started back, we'll say, 25 years ago?
Well, I would have to – I don't know the magnitude of the contracts now, but I would only assume that they're a lot more tighter now, especially given the money that these teams are really investing in. So at the end of the day, they really want to make sure that their product, that their individual or safe and sound and really, really focus on the things at hand.
Right. Okay, so, and I talked to one of your former 49ers alums, and that was Bill Romanowski. And Bill's he's a great guy to talk to and one of the biggest hitters the game has ever seen, right? And so Bill told me, and I asked him about that proverbial week off, the extra weeks off and stuff. You know, you have those resting games where we're gonna rest the body for a game or two here or there. What do you think about what that does to the psyche of the player, not being able to play every game because you're playing once a week? And now let's say you have a bye week and then you have another week off, whatever. So it's load management kind of thing. Because Bill said, look, I never wanted to take a down off, let alone a game off. What do you think about load management in the NFL today versus when you played?
I think it's important. I think it's important because, you know, just with the technology and the new information that we've gotten over these last few years, over this decade, as far as with information on being healthy and that whole thing there, load management is extremely important. But at the same time, I think it's a case-by-case situation. Everybody's body operates a little different than the other. I know for me, as I got older in my career, you know, my coach allowed some of the older guys to be able to take more of a couple of days off during the week so that we can kind of recover, because my body recovered a whole lot different than maybe someone else. So you have to be very cognizant of that at the end of the day. But the way things are now with the teams and how they do training camp now seems to be a little bit more than necessary, because over time your body really needs to be able to have it needs to be active. It needs to be on the move. It needs to be on a continual basis. So too much resting cannot be good for you, in my opinion.
Well, now, especially going to 17 games coming up too, you know, in future seasons, we're going to see maybe in a year or so, they're going to add one extra regular season, but they're going to take one off of the preseason. But now you've got an extra game that counts, which obviously the player, it's good for the players and players are going to get paid, but it's bad for the players because now they got an extra game. So maybe that load management thing will kind of work itself out over the next year or so. What do you think?
I think it's going to work itself out eventually, but I am sure that there are going to be some kinks in this thing and they're going to have to figure it out. You know, I think we're going to eventually start seeing some problems here or there with guys of how they're handling that extra game because it is a load. You know, I think for the most part, athletes sometimes don't think it's a lot or people don't think it's a lot, but that one game, it's a lot on the body. It's a lot on the mind. And so I think eventually there are going to be some kinks that has to be adjusted to, but we're going to see some things that happens on the early onslaught of it.
Right. Okay. In our last minute here, I want you to answer this real quick. Let's think about the pass interference instant replay situation, right? And it's got to bring a chuckle to you because, I mean, you're just doing your job out there, right? And there's a little bit of clutching and grabbing, but what do you think about the idea of having this pass interference instant replay nonsense, which is going to be done away with real quick?
I'm kind of for it, but then I'm kind of against it really. You know, I just like to go out there and play and put the, you know, put it on the official's hand to make the right call. But again, I think if they stay consistent with the calls, it could be okay.
Yeah, it certainly can be okay. I wonder a lot of times because, you know, people are always crying especially if you're here in Vegas. Now, you've been in these sports books, and there's 5,000-10,000 people at a time sometimes in these sports books hooting and hollering and screaming, and it's just like being at the game. But at the same time, people are crying and complaining and saying, oh, that was a terrible call and all this other crap. Right. And so now they can actually dispute it, but then again, they can't. We're going to get back into that when we're back here with Walt Harris, All-Pro and Pro Bowl cornerback, in just a few minutes here on the Circus. Don't go anywhere.
Can't beat fun at the old ballpark, friends. High pop fly. That one be a home run in a phone booth. I don't know what the big deal about Cracker Jack is. Did you ever go and buy a pack of Cracker Jack thinking you'd get a prize and find no prize in the box? Here's the pitch. That might not sound important to some people, but when you're a little kid, especially from humble origin, and they cheat you out of a prize. There's a bouncing ball. Second baseman has a Barbary over the first. It's hard to think in laudatory terms of the product.
I think if there was an occasional box of Cracker Jacks that found no prizes for the little Harry Carey many years ago.
You got that right. And boy, when a box of Cracker Jack to me meant a lot of money. Here's a pitch, bounce foul. That's the most asinine marketing I've ever heard of. One ball, one strike. These guys say, well, you sing about Cracker Jack. I said that I only sing it because it's in the song. Here's a pitch, foul back. And I wouldn't be a bit surprised, even to this day, some youngsters who buy a box of Cracker Jack don't find a prize in the box. One ball, two strikes, two out. Well, if you're going to talk about our congressman being crooked, here's a pitch foul out of play. Why not talk about commercial products who don't do what they represent to do? They told me when they hired me it was a temporary job. Born and raised in St. Louis, and you can imagine the Cardinals were my favorite team from the day I could remember. And all of a sudden, the miracle of life, I'm broadcasting card games. Yeah. I own the town and broadcast them for 25 years, and I thought they're going to give me a gold watch, and they gave me a pink slip. Then I went out to work for Charlie Finley for a year, and that's par for the course. Came to Chicago, and I was with the White Sox 11 years, and now with the Cubs. Never missed a game, never missed a time at bat, never missed a half inning that I was supposed to do. You know, Chicago is such a marvelous city. Hey, we got some Chicago people. You know, you never succeed in this business until you've had the experience of working with a terrible hangover. Not until you've been able to come through with flying colors under those circumstances can you consider yourself a professional. Lord knows, I've had more than my share of hangovers.
There's a drive, way back, it might be, it could be, and it. Holy cow, this crowd is wild.
Hey, this is Tommy John, and you're listening to the Sports Circus.
Welcome back to the Sports Circus. I'm your Ringmaster Sal, live from the AMP-TV mobile studio here in fabulous Las Vegas. That's AAMP-TV. That stands for All Ages Media Programming. Folks, make sure that you also check out the Sports Circus on our CBS, NBC, and Fox Sports affiliates. If you're not doing it already, you may be watching us on hotel television. You may be watching us on YouTube. You just hit the subscribe button as well. And a big welcome back to everybody also streaming at thesportscircus.com and on Facebook. Folks, make sure you also check out thesportscircus.com for our upcoming guest, our prior guest, our podcast. And also, we have some really good partners. In fact, we may be talking about one of those future partners. Maybe a little bit of logo action might be on for something called the OPP for Walt Harris, our superstar all-pro guest, cornerback. And that played, of course, with the Chicago Bears and the San Francisco 49ers, among others. Hey, Walt, tell everybody quickly about OPP, would you?
Yes. OPP stands for, and I want to make sure everyone don't get it mixed up. OPP stands for Official Pro Players. Official Pro Players Incorporated, that's an organization, a 501c3 organization that I started maybe over 3-4 years ago. And it's a collective group of all professional athletes on one platform. And we just try to convey a positive image on and off the field. We try to collectively be an impact in our communities as well as increasing the sports community as a whole. I think for what I know, this is the only organization that's collectively have all professional athletes together, whether you are a professional baseball player, hockey, soccer, you know, it's a growing network of professional athletes all together on one platform. And we're finding ways to support other organizations as well as finding ways to help and give back to our communities.
All right, that's good stuff. Well, that's one of those partners we need to have on the partners page for the Sports Circus. We'll have to talk about that outside the show. Okay. That's good stuff, though. I love it because the thing that struck me right was when you said off the field. Off the field's a really big deal. There's a lot of players, I don't care what your sport is, sometimes they just act a fool off the field. They think they can do whatever they want and they create havoc and mayhem, which a little bit of chaos is okay in our lives. But I mean, look, you're a pro, whether you like it or not, you are a role model for the kids, period. Speak to that for a moment, would you?
Absolutely. And that's one of the things, reason why I really felt Official Pro Players would be a huge impact and is important because it helps your mindset to understand just because you're retired, just because you're maybe not on the field at that time, that you're not a professional. And so we as athletes have to understand and understand it's important that we carry ourselves well on and off the field. And that's the things that we want to always highlight. We want to find those individuals, those professional athletes that are doing positive things out in their communities, whether they're sustaining their families, whether they're being a huge impact on huge causes. We want to highlight that, and we want them to be a part of the Official Pro Players Network. So we like to call it, are you down with OPP? And again, it's not the old OPP, but it's definitely, are you down with Official Pro Players? Because we want to be down with any professional athletes that are carrying a positive image on and off the field is vital.
Yeah, absolutely vital. And listen, outside of that, outside of just the athletes, look, this goes for our community leaders. This goes for the business people, and this goes for the moms and dads out there, for their kids to be good around the clock, not just when you're on the clock. Agree or disagree?
Absolutely. Absolutely. You just hit the nail right on the head with that. And so just because we're athletes, but everyone has certain titles. And so we don't want, because we leave that atmosphere, that we take that helmet off or that hat off or whatever that name tag off, and all of a sudden we change it to something else that's not as positive as it should be if you're on the job. Carry yourself the same way that you would carry yourself at your job, whether it's at home or where it is in the community. That's what we want.
Yeah, you know, that's kind of like the old, hey, look, do something good when no one's looking.
Yes.
Don't look for a pat on the head. Don't look for some kudos from somebody else or whatever it is. I don't care about that. That's accountability.
Right. That's, yeah, let understand that's who you are. That should be your makeup. And that's what I want. You know, that's why we try to convey that with those individuals that are off the field as well. You know, you're great at your sport on the field, but we also want to highlight the things that you're doing off the field, because I think there's always carryover in a positive way with that, with professional athletes.
Yeah. Okay. So let's talk a little bit more about life after football. After I ask you just another couple questions about pass interference. Yeah. Now, look, everybody in the world has seen it. Everybody saw the obvious pass interference call, right? The no call, better yet, between the Rams and the Saints. And look, that could have changed had there been instant replay used at that moment. Let's face it, you would have seen the Saints likely in the Super Bowl, and that would have been a very interesting game between Brees and Brady instead of an inexperienced quarterback with Jared Goff against Bill Belichick, a mastermind. Agree or disagree?
I totally agree. I totally agree. And we all know it doesn't take replay to even have to see that, really, you know, because at the end of the day, we're watching it, we see it, and we want to put the responsibility back to me sometimes in the official's hand to make the right call. And if you don't make the right call, then there need to be some, you know, accountability on that as well.
Right. Folks, we're back here with Walt Harris, All-Pro and Pro Bowl cornerback from the National Football League, and also a state champion from LaGrange, Georgia, too. You had that over Tyrone Poole. And we talked about that, I think, in the first segment. Tyrone had his big Super Bowl ring up behind him. And it was just, it was bigger than my head. And very few things are bigger than my head, Walt. Got to tell you that much.
Your head is not that big, Zach. It's not that big.
As I get closer to the camera, you'll see it's really large.
Okay.
But nonetheless, I think about the idea that, look, people are champions in their own worlds. And now you think about the cornerback position, which is, it's a very tough position. Look, you played for what, 14, 15 years? That's a lot of years. Man, that's a lot of years. And let's face it, whether you're first round or last round, it doesn't matter. The fact is, you had, as a first rounder, you had all those years, strength and conditioning, but you also had to evolve kind of as the rules evolved as well, didn't you?
Absolutely. Absolutely. It's a lot different now than the way that it was at the beginning. You know, we were allowed to do a lot more things physically on the line with the receivers and much longer. But nowadays it's changed. And so you have to evolve as a defensive back, as an athlete in general, you're going to have to evolve. But we as defensive backs had to evolve extremely fast because the next season things change and now you got to adjust.
Yeah, lots of adjustments. And let's face it, I mean, life has adjustments too. Even as you're after pro football career, for the last several years, how have you seen yourself evolve into a community leader? Now, are you in the greater Atlanta market currently?
Yeah, I mean, I'm in the Atlanta market, also in Florida. I'm back and forth. And so one of the things, I'm the vice president with the former players association well. And so you have to evolve. The way that I evolved off the field, it took me some time, really, because, you know, when you have only played this sport for so long in your life, and these are the things that you're focused on, there's a transition process. But one of the things that I told myself is that once I'm done, and when I was done, I got to get active and go out and find ways to help other individuals. And when you do that, you start finding your calling, you start finding yourself again. And that's what I did. And it really helped me out. And now it's just all about helping other individuals to just be better, do better. And so that we can have greater communities, greater places.
Yeah, I think that's really important. I think a lot of people miss the boat on that. They say, well, hey, you know, these guys and ladies, you know, they play professional sports. And what are they doing for the community when they get out? Is it just about rolling up in their Benz, or is it about actually doing something for other people? And I think, I mean, look, we were put on this planet to do what? To make it a better place and leave it a better place than when we found it. Agree or disagree?
Absolutely. Absolutely. We're here for a reason. That's the thing that we all have to know. You know, we all serve a purpose. We're going to serve a good positive purpose, or we're going to serve a purpose that's not good for our community, is not good for our homes. And so we have to be aware of that.
Yep. Okay. Let's see if Sonar, our engineer, has a question for you. Let's see if he's asleep over there.
So when you were running track, what was your favorite? I mean, you were talking about hurdling and things, but was that it? Did you do any long jumping, or God forbid you ran with one of those poles for the high jump?
No, I didn't do that one. Pole vaulting and high jumping, I did not do that. Triple jump, I did not do any of that. I ran hurdles, ran the 300 hurdles, the 4x4 mile relays and those things, and I hated them every time. I didn't like it because I didn't like the feeling after we were done with the mile relay, which is always at the end, and there's so much that builds up in your behind, and it's just an uncomfortable feeling, so I hated it. But I did do some of the other events such as those, but my specialty was really running the hurdles, jumping the hurdles.
Yeah, I know that one, man. I did the long jump, the triple jump, once in a while the high jump, but long jump, triple jump, I did the quarter mile and mile relay. And, you know, that 400 and 1600, they were back to back.
Wow.
And you just, you know, you're burning, your lungs are burning. I'm like, oh man. And, you know, literally you got what, 2-3 minutes to rest. Like, all right, everybody get ready. And I was the anchor guy. The good news is, cause I had maybe an extra, 2 minutes to rest, but that's about it. But at the end of the day, man, you get that baton and you just run like the wind, but your lungs are on fire.
You just telling me that just gained extra respect for you on that, because again, like I said, I did not like the mile relay, that the last event of the sport. And so you did that right before, man, hats off to you big time on that, Sal.
Buddy, that was murder. That was absolute murder. I mean, I love the fact of running basically 2.5 blocks as fast as I can, because I figured, you know, if my old man was chasing me down the street, I can outlast him down the street. You know, there's not really much of a problem with that. But the problem is then if he gets in the car and he cuts me off, then I got to run another 2.5 blocks to get away from him. That kind of thing.
You had strategy.
And then
again,
it sounds like you had burning, strategy. You know? All right. Hey, listen, Walt, we're running on time. Again, give everybody a quick summary on OPP, how to follow you, and how to get in touch.
Yep. You can go to officialproplayers.org and you'll see our website there. You can also follow us at Official Pro Players on Instagram as well as Facebook. You can follow me at The Real Walt Harris on both social media platforms as well. And so Official Pro Players is basically about bringing all professional athletes, former and past athletes together, and whether it's men or women, collectively together on one platform. And our goal is to convey positive images on and off the field, on and off the court, and help build our communities together collectively.
Well, for everybody listening in Honolulu on the 49ers radio network, and of course, for all those Chicago Bears fans like me, Walt, it was great to see you on that field. It's great to have you on the show today. Big round of applause for Walt Harris, All-Pro and Pro Bowl cornerback with those teams and some others. But remember, go Bears!
That's right.
We'll see you next time. Thanks for joining us, Walt. And we'll see you next time here on the circus. So long, everyone.
So, you want to be in show business. Do people tell you that you're really funny, you have a great personality, and you should have your own talk show? Many of us have been told that, but we don't know how to get started. It's easier than you think. Let the pros at Cali Vegas give you a free talent evaluation. Call 949-445-1119 and learn how quickly you can create, produce, and host your very own talk show. Imagine not having to sit in traffic every day, commuting back and forth to the same old boring job. Get started in television or radio today with your free talent evaluation from Cali Vegas. Call 949-445-1119 or visit them online at calivegas.com. Make your dream come true today and create your new career and learn how to become a television or radio star with the help of Cali Vegas. 949-445-1119. Call now.